to greet you. Is in chaos. But there is yet hope. Here is Martin Septim, true son of Uriel Septim.
Hail, Dragonborn!
Hail, Martin Septim!
Your Highness, the blades are at your command. You will be safe here until you can take up your throne.
All of you, I know you all expect me to be Emperor. I'll do my best. But this is all new to me. I'm not used to giving speeches, but I wanted you to know that I appreciate your welcome here. I hope I prove myself worthy of your loyalty in the coming days. That's it. Thank you.
Well then, thank you, Martin. We'd all best get back to our duties, eh, Captain?
Not much of a speech, was it? Didn't seem to bother them, though. The blade saluting me and hailing me as Martin Septim. I don't mean to sound ungrateful. I know I would be dead by now if it weren't for you. Thank you. But everyone expects me to suddenly know what to do, how to behave. They want an emperor to tell them what to do, and I haven't the faintest idea. Of course, the Amulet of Kings. So I can take it to the Temple of the One and light the dragon fires and stop the Oblivion invasion. The Emperor? That's an idea that will take some getting used to. In any case, we need the amulet first. Maybe Joffrey will know where to start. All practitioners of Daedric magic are familiar with the almost impenetrable barrier between our world and Oblivion. What the Emperor told you implies that the amulet is the key to the preservation of that barrier. What I saw at Kavach, everything I know about Daedric magic says that such stable portals are impossible. Yet those gates to Oblivion existed. The old rules no longer apply. Kavach is only the beginning of what Mehrunes Dagon will do. If the amulet is truly the key to restoring the barriers between our world and Oblivion, you must waste no time in recovering it. I haven't always been a priest. In my youth, I followed a different path. I know more than I want to about the seductive power of Daedric magic. Let's just leave it at that. Something has changed to make these stable portals to Oblivion possible. Joffrey believes that the death of the Emperor and the darkening of the Dragonfires is the key. Something has changed to make these stable portals to Oblivion possible. Joffrey believes that the death of the Emperor and the darkening of the Dragonfires is the key. Don't worry about me, my
friend. Good evening, sir.
I know I'm in good hands here.
You have proven yourself a loyal servant of the Empire, as worthy as any of the Blades to stand by Martin's side during this crisis. As the Grand Master of the Blades, I would be honored to accept you into our order. Will you join us? It is my honor to welcome you into our ranks as a Knight Brother of the Blades.
Thank you.
You're right. We must try to recover the amulet before the enemy takes it out of our reach. You should go back to the Imperial City. Boris may have learned something about the assassins. You'll find Boris at Luther Broad's boarding house in the Elven Gardens district of the Imperial City. The Amulet of Kings is the key to everything now. Once we have it back, Martin can use it to light the dragonfires in the Temple of the One and reseal the barriers between Oblivion and our world. This place was built by Raymond Cyrodiil Zakaviri Dragonguard at the founding of the Second Empire. Since then, it has served the Blades as headquarters, fortress, and sanctuary. We can protect Martin here until you recover the Amulet of Kings. This fortress is well supplied with arms and armor. Use what you need from the armory in the East Wing. Give my warm regards to Boris. Tell him he should not blame himself for the Emperor's death. He did well to send you to me.
Thank you.
sound ungrateful. I know I would be dead by now if it weren't for you. Thank you. But everyone expects me to suddenly know what to do, how to behave. They want an emperor to tell them what to do, and I haven't the faintest idea. Of course, the Amulet of Kings. So I can take it to the Temple of the One and light the dragonfires and stop the Oblivion of your loyalty in the coming days.
Thank you.
Not much of a speech.
Deal to you today, Captain. We'd all best get back to our duty today, Captain.
Not much of a speech, was it? Didn't seem to bother them, though. The blade saluting me and hailing me as Martin Septim. I don't mean to sound ungrateful. I know I would be dead by now if it weren't for you. Thank you. But everyone expects me to suddenly know what to do, how to behave. They want an emperor to tell them what to do, and I haven't the faintest idea.
Yourself a loyal servant of the Empire, as worthy as any of the Blades to stand by Martin's side during this crisis. As the Grand Master of the Blades, I would be honored to accept you into our order. Will you join us? It is my honor to welcome you into our ranks as a Knight Brother of the Blades. You're right. We must try to recover the amulet before the enemy takes it out of our reach. You should go back to the Imperial City. Boris may have learned something about the assassins. You'll find Boris at Luther Broad's boarding house in the Elven Gardens district of the Imperial City. The Amulet of Kings is the key to everything now. Once we have it back, Martin can use it to light the dragonfires in the Temple of the One and reseal the barriers between Oblivion and our world. This place was built by Raymond Cyrodiil Zakaviri Dragonguard at the founding of the Second Empire. Since then, It has served the Blades as headquarters, fortress, and sanctuary. We can protect Martin here until you recover the Amulet of Kings. This fortress is well supplied with arms and armor. Use what you need from the armory in the East Wing. Give my warm regards to Boris. Tell him he should not blame himself for the Emperor's death. He did well to send you. Forgive me, but I'm afraid I haven't got time to talk right now. One of the other Blades should be able to assist you. But try General Stefan. Thank you.
being heir to the throne takes some getting used to. Please bear with me.
Thank you. Thank you. Mm-hmm.